All right, checking it out. Here we are back again with our 14 to 16. Here's the run on. Will Wolves Harvey do this one? 1-2-2 on the outside. Wolves Harvey 108 all on the inside. Been a great battle between these guys. And certainly, it was all about Aiden. Aiden had his birthday here on Friday. It was effectively was a day too late. And had it been the previous day, he would have started when he was 13, but to be 14, he started in his class. And at 12 to 13, he would have been a dynamic rider up and amongst them. And here he is, of course, with this diluted field. But Wills Harvey is the man to claim more of the glory. And Aiden will deservedly end up as number two. What have you been doing in the other club? Well, you never know, do you? You never know what you don't know. But here he is, the youngest of the riders out there at only 14 years of age as of Friday of this week. So out there with Fogatani's Aiden Hall on the Brady Motorsport, MXD Custom Decals, Patterson O'Connor Motorcycles, Chase Work Suspension, 6040 Milking, Drain Tech. So KTM 85 Pilot and Aiden Hall. And speaking of Fogatani, of course, Summercross. The 50th edition of Summercross coming up this Super Summer, so looking out for it, of course. That's December 28th, 29th at the all-conquering venue, the famous Awa Kaponga, the home of the Bay Plenty Motorcycle Club. So it will be an absolutely sensational two-day event, as it always is. One of New Zealand's premier events, creme de la creme. More riders than most other events, more riders than other events added together ever dream of. So one of our all-time biggest events, and I think really probably only Woodville that it may rival in overall rider numbers. So it is a sensation. It's a beautiful part of the country to be. It's a great time of year to be up there. You will love it. Riding for minis, riding for juniors, riding for seniors, vets, women's, they're all there, and it's all part of it. The fabulous Awa Kaponga Circuit, the home of the Bay of Plenty Club, Summercross. So check it out. December 28, 29, we'll be there for the 50th anniversary. Hope to have you there as well. Make it your summer vacation destination. All right, what do you do for Will? Will's Harvey! Up and over the top, it's Will's has got the advantage, along with 100. And Aiden up there, then looking to third. Wow, here we are. We've been talking about the two riders in the bike battle, but we've also got Lockie McLaren. We should have had Lockie all along. He's had some terrible bad luck over the weekend. So Lockie McLaren, the Napier man, on that Motorland Yamaha New Zealand Blue Crew Alpine Star Crown Kiwi Enterprises 100% Workshop Graphic Sam Harvey Training Mayfair Pools Motorware SAR Carter Coaching FMX Hawke's Bay, along with Iron Force Trailers Hawke's Bay Heavy Haul, along with Longhorn Transport and LM Graphic Design. So Lockie McLaren in full flight there in that third place. Wouldn't it have been great to see all of these three riders over each other like a rash, breathing fire into this class through race after race after race. And they're not too far away from that at the moment. It'd be great to have a fitting finale with these three fighting it out and all. So pretty darn cool to see. All right, just two motos to go, folks, and it's all the ladies. We saved the best till last. The ladies are lined up with the combo 8 to 11 and 12 to 1685s next, and the last race of the day with our 125 and 250. So here we are, time at the moment just a little after 1:30. Guesstimated time finish at around 2 to 2:30 this afternoon, and of course time to pack up and be ready to go with prize giving from 4 this afternoon at the Taranaki Raceway. So great to see you all out here, and many of you making the trip to enjoy us. I presume we probably must have started with Bathurst already by now as well, haven't we? I understand it's terrible weather over there. They couldn't even have Super Pole yesterday. There was so much water on the track. They had a bad forecast, and I think it's probably come true for them over there. It's one of our Kiwi days where we sit back and enjoy it on the couches at home. We'll miss most of it this year, but I'm not too worried about that. We've certainly, I feel we're in a better place. All right, let's see it out there. 1-2-2 for Wills. 100 on the inside for Aiden. And here we are now with Lockie, and Lockie McLaren picking it up in the second on that 381 numbered Yamaha. Wills Harvey pulling out the stop, though, that's for sure. And then we go to Ollie all the way, 219, Ollie Corbin, the Danny Vegas man there on the AFC CSL. JW Seats, Stux, LM Graphics, Sam Harvey training bike. Then looking now to 188, 717 in there, Jaden McKenzie as well, out of Clevedon. Looking for 288 and Deacon Cox out of Ocato here on the Gas 85, along with 253, Charlie Cameron out of Martinborough. And there we are with our 28 that time. Archie McCullum, you remember the Thames rider Archie? He actually stole the show and led to the top of the hill from a whole shot start here yesterday afternoon. So had his moment of glory for the Thames rider Archie McCullum. So picking up on our race pace here at the moment, 1-2-2 for Wills Harvey, the man from Appleby in Nelson, on the Nelson motorcycles, Dyno Works, Total Lubricants, Troy Lee Design, Maxxis Tyres, H&H Digger Hire Motocross Events, supported KTM 85, so good work from Wills. Here he is, 1-2-2, powers his way up the front. Former New Zealand mini top three rider, North Island champion as well. Top Taupo winner, of course, part of our contingent 2018 to the World Juniors in Australia. So a well-acclaimed rider of national significance and on the verge of his first ever national junior title. So well done to Wills Harvey. 188 for Wanganui's Finn Lennox out there on the DS motorcycles. 188 training tracks, supported Husqvarna 85. Yo, 717, Jaden McKenzie. Looking out for 288, Deacon Cox. .253 that time, and Mark Burrows, Charlie Cameron on the Sergeant Motorcycles, Mum and Dad, Blue Crew, Motul, Chase Works, Carter Coaching Bike. Speaking about Martin Burrow, we'll be there for the Wairarapa Champs on the last weekend of November. Super busy time at the moment with mega events all stacked up on themselves. So we've got a great November in store with having the Waikato Champs, the Auckland Champs and the Wairarapa Champs. So three out of the 4 weekends take it up with some great racing. We'll also be in Christchurch for the Extreme Enduro at the Christchurch AMP show on Friday the 11th of November for Christchurch show day. And what about the Sand Champs? I'm sure you should have added the Sand Champs in there as well. It's a new double header, by the way, with the Gold Coast Club. The Sand Champs are going to do Taikaria on the Saturday, Taikaria on the Saturday, Gold Coast on the Sunday. So, or Motuiti for the Gold Coast Club. So, in fact, all four. So, let me correct that. First weekend is Waikato Champs. Second weekend is New Zealand Sand Champs. Third weekend is Auckland Champs. And fourth weekend is Wairarapa Champs. So four great events over that month. So take an opportunity to check it out. This new format for the Sand Champs will be amazing to have the two different tracks, Taikaria and Motuiti, and proved very popular. A lot of people from around the country have been travelling to use those events. I know they've been coming up from the Nelson region, they've been coming across from Hawke's Bay, down from Tauranga, Auckland and the like. So putting together a double header for that event. Now, many times you see events that are in line with one track over 2 days. This has actually got two different tracks over 2 days, but two very well acclaimed sand tracks. You want to look for all the developments going on at Taikaria as well.
Here, our Alpine Stars aboard 40 to 16 years, 85, but 2 minutes plus one lap to go. Wills Harvey, again, the perfect weekend. Four race wins from four starts, four times fastest lap. And already the fastest lap in this one here. So well on his way to total domination. Maximum 100 points in the bank. He's got a 14-point lead. But hasn't settled for that. Wants to go out on a winning tangent here. 122, Will Tarby on the Nelson motorcycle, supported KTM85. Crossing the line there and ticking off yet another lap with the clock saying there's about a minute 36 left to go, so the white flag will come out next time around. So starting to get excited for Will Tarby. Good performance in 15 to 16 years, 125 action, but this is where he has shown his way. Brilliant stuff. Lockie McLaren in second place at the moment. That will easily be his best performance so far this weekend. He's actually just getting better and better and better as the weekend's gone on. So great to have Lockie there running top two, showing how good he is. Coming into this race, fifth in the points on 64. So to grab 22 massive championship points, could find himself climbing at least a 4NZ. Hayden Hall there, he's the one in third place for this one here. He's second in the championship, 4 points ahead of Connor Heavey. So if he can hang on to that third in this race, 2NZ will be in his sights. Ollie Corbin, the one there in fourth place in this race, so doing everything he can to hang on to his fourth overall. But definitely starting to get to the business end of this one here. Thank you to Alpine Stars supporting this one here. 14 to 16 years, Premier 85 CC Racing. And it's been the man from the mainland on the Nelson Motorcycles machine. He has not put a foot wrong all weekend. As he fires it round and ready to go. White flag ready and waiting for this man here. As we get excited for the 122. White flag out now. Will Tarby starts his final lap and on his way to glory. In 14 to 16 year 85 racing, Lockie McLaren all alone in second place. This is going to feel real good. You come away from the Junior Nationals and you put your best performance out there in the last one. Just built nicely into the weekend. And a pretty good performance as well, Aidan Hall on the number 100 from the Eastern Bay of Plenty, where we will be for Summer Cross. Can't wait for that one there, the 50th anniversary event. And here's the 100, Aidan Hall. He'll tick off yet another lap. White flag out, the last lap of his junior championships is on. Here's the 219, Ollie Corbin on the AFC Moto CSL white machine. Double classing as well on the 12 to 14 years, 125, so... big weekend at the office for Team Corbin Racing, and Ollie doing a fantastic job. Fourth in the championship coming into this one, but with Lockie doing a great result, getting that 22 points. It'll be interesting to see where it all plays out. And there's 13 entries in all. Good top five result from Finn Lennox on the cards as well. He's got one more lap to hang on to that one there. And Deacon Cox in sixth place with the 717. But Jaden McKenzie, we're rounding out seventh at the moment. But now we're going to get really excited because our man who had a massive points lead heading into this race is about to bring it home. From Appleby, Nelson Motorcycle Centre team has been flawless all weekend. The 122 has got a couple of corners to go. Nothing can stop him now. This is going to be brilliant. Into the right-hander and up Horsepower Hill. Here's another national champion. This is going to feel good. Well under Will Tarby, your 14 to 16 years New Zealand champion for 2022. That is absolutely breathtaking. He's won every single race as well as top qualifier. Just the perfect weekend. Shout out to the 224, Riley Westgate. He'll come home. That'll be ninth place finish for him. And then to Connor Heafy, who'll come home in 10th in this race. Third in the points, so we'll see how that works out. Here's Lockie McLaren, go 381, Lockie. He'll come through in second place, and that will help him with his overall championship credentials, that's for sure. Here's Aidan, he had a 4-point lead over Connor, hitting this one, Connor having the bad luck, so this will seal this one away for 2NZ. Aidan Hall, well done, Aidan. Number 2NZ, 14 to 16 racing. Here's Ollie Corbin, so well done, Ollie. Consistent weekend, for Ollie. Fantastic results all across the board on the 219 machine. That's another fourth place locked away for him. And it'll be interesting to see how we play out in our final point score. But that is a wrap of our 14 to 16 years Alpine Star supported 85cc racing. It's a national championship for Wills Harvey and a 2NZ for Aidan Hall. But that's where my mass runs out. We'll have to let the computer work out the next positions. Certainly going to be exciting to see. As we crank on with our program, up next we've got our junior 85cc ladies, the two classes out there, 12 to 16 years on the right-hand side of the start line, and on the left, our junior 8 to 11 years 85cc ladies coming up next.